Doom has come a long way in terms of modding. Once there was a set of level editors, but then Dehacked was released, an editor that modifies the Doom's executable file to make certain changes, like changing the names of levels shown on the automap, to even full-blown gameplay mods like Boiled Doom, a demake of Brutal Doom that runs on the vanilla Doom engine. But over the years, Doom modding has seen various flavors, from Dehacked total conversions to even mods exclusive to GZ Doom. But today, we're going to talk about one of the most impressive works I have ever seen for the DOS versions of Doom. Yes, we're talking about the Ace engine, an engine modification for Doom 2 that makes use of arbitrary code execution, an exploit that allows programmers to run commands or code of choice. The exploit was discovered by a member of Doomworld, the same member who also developed KGZ Doom, a fork of Z Doom from 2005. Ace Engine was being developed as early as September 2020 as a save game exploit, but would later become a WAD exploit. I have covered this project back in October 2020, showcasing its possibilities you could achieve using the Ace Engine, like playing Snake and making use of certain features like mouse look, color lighting, and fog. Ace Engine also has support for certain features from other Doom Engine games, like loading maps that were made in the hex and map format, and limited support for certain features as seen in ZDoom. A demo release of Ace Engine version 2 finally released on June 6, 2023, so let's take a look. One thing to note is that an untouched copy of Doom 2 version 1.9 is required to run the Ace Engine, and it's as simple as using the file parameter. I will be playing this on my Pentium 75 MHz machine with Windows 95 installed for this video. Ace Engine greets you with a scripted introduction, showcasing some of the features you would have already seen in modern source ports, like custom monsters and weapons using ZDoom's Decorate language. The fact that it's added to the vanilla engine without making source code changes is amazing. Oh, and it even has a save system similar to Duke Nukem 3D. On top of that, you can add things like weapons with alternative fires, invisible enemies that drop blood, inventory items like grenades, and you can even have arch files that resurrect each other. I see the maps from this demo is inspired by Half-Life, but it was fun to play. The goal is to obtain 3 skull keys in order to complete the level, and in each place to get these keys shows off the possibilities you can achieve making maps for the Ace Engine, like blowing up geometry similar to Duke Nukem 3D, climbing on ladders, room above room, pushing sprite objects, and much more. Not only you can have custom weapons and monsters, but you can have different player classes too. This is also demonstrated with you playing as a chicken in a minigame called Pecking Order. I also love the arsenal in this demo, which is basically a mix between various games, like the Uzis and Riot Guns from Shadow Warrior, the Shotgun from Duke Nukem 3D, the Ethereal Crossbow from Heretic that also uses Demon Essence as ammo, and my personal favorite, the Timon's Axe from Hexen. It's also cool to use when using the Invulnerability power-up. I had a lot of fun playing this demo on my Pentium machine, and I hope to see more features for this project in the near future. Now, I heard there's also multiplayer capabilities for the Ace Engine, but I haven't tested it out yet to give any input on it. That about wraps up this video. I hope to see more people from the Doom community make some cool projects with this engine as time goes on. Also, don't forget to check out the Doomworld thread and the GitHub repository in the description down below. As always, thank you all for watching and peace out.